Breaking, Kaepernick just released his own Bill of Rights and is forcing everyone in America to follow it. Retirement for most professional athletes means starting a new career, usually taking on some supporting role in sports. Coaching is an option, as well as commentating, etc. But for Colin Kaepernick, the athlete who was forced into retirement because of his objectionable political displays on the field, those weren't options. The NFL might be willing to take a risk on letting the national anthem protest continue, but the teams don't seem to be willing to take a risk on Kaepernick. At this point in his life, he's relegated to writing and apparently passing on his wisdom to the next generation. That's right, the man who single-handedly ruined one of America's favorite sports is now teaching others how to do the same. They say that those who can't do, teach, and Kaepernick is proving that to be true. The conservative Tribune reports that the former NFL quarterback turned social justice warrior is trying to rally support from the small fries these days. Apparently, he's spending his time teaching kids what rights they should demand out in the world. Kaepernick walked away from his contract with San Francisco following last season and no team has signed him thus far, but the former quarterback hasn't been sitting around doing nothing this year instead of playing. Rather, he has hit the road as a social justice warrior, using his own money to start up the Colin Kaepernick Foundation, which is committed to a mission to fight oppression globally, through education and social activism. Essentially, since he's unable to play football, he's fallen back on the thing that made him famous, protesting things. While on the surface, those goals sound like things we should all aspire to, it's worth taking a closer look at his plan to achieve them. One method by which the ex-NFL player has worked to achieve that goal is through funding, hosting and organizing day-long workshops in various cities that are dubbed the Know Your Rights Camp. The camp is described as a free campaign for youth, fully funded by Colin Kaepernick to raise awareness on higher education, self-empowerment, and instruction to properly interact with law enforcement in various scenarios. It appears that Kaepernick is taking his objections about how police treat people to the streets. This is a grassroots effort to teach people how to interact with police, and while we hope that the lessons are things like obey the law and always be respectful, there's a good chance that the syllabus sounds more like a Black Power salute. For a look inside one of Kaepernick's camps, check out this gushing rundown of the day's events in May on the south side of Chicago by the ultra-progressive The Nation, if you can stomach the over-the-top leftism. An integral part of the event is teaching the Black, brown, and economically disadvantaged youth, in attendance by invitation only, about their rights, but not the constitutional Bill of Rights we all are familiar with. Instead, these 10 rights are specifically derived from the political legacy of the Black Panthers, a radical racial leftist political organization. The rights that Kaepernick is teaching urban youth about are: 1. You have the right to be free. 2. You have the right to be healthy. 3. You have the right to be brilliant. 4. You have the right to be safe. 5. You have the right to be loved. 6. You have the right to be courageous. 7. You have the right to be alive. 8. You have the right to be trusted. 9. You have the right to be educated. 10. You have the right to know your rights. By our count, only 3 of the rights mentioned on the list are actual rights as laid out by our nation's founders, namely the right to be free, safe and alive. All of the rest are vague generalizations of an optimal lifestyle that can be obtained through hard work and sacrifice, or earned, as in the case of being loved and trusted. Sadly, many of the tenets laid out as rights are things that people want to have without working for. This might not be the definition of economic socialism, but it's not far from it in mindset. The idea that you have a right to be loved sounds good, but what if you make yourself unlovable? You also don't have a right to be trusted, if you're engaging in untrustworthy actions. If you're curious about how he's teaching kids to interact with law enforcement, that's addressed as well. Apparently, that teaching consisted mainly of asking the officer, "Am I free to go?" and refusing to consent to searches or speak until they have an attorney present. All of Kaepernick's cures to these problems are completely consistent with his worldview. If the country really was in the state that he believes it to be in, This would be a completely logical answer to the issues at hand. The problem is that the worldview was built on lies, told by those who want to manipulate the direction of cultural growth for their own personal gain.